contestant 5287 competing in the baking and pastries art contest. First, I'm going to be doing the sugar cookie recipe, and then I'm going to be doing the braided bread. So first, I have my oven already preheated, and I have all my ingredients already measured out. And then attached here is the right here is the conversion for my sugar cookie recipe, where I divided everything by 4, and so I already measured those all out, so they are ready to be prepared. So first I'm going to dice my butter into small dices, which then I'm going to cream with my sugar. So now I'm going to add my butter into here, which then I'm going to cream with my sugar. Now I'm going to add my sugar into the butter, then cream. Put the butter and the sugar in here. I'm also going to add my salt. So now I'm going to push down my butter. And then add my vanilla. And then my 2 eggs, which actually cracked an egg. And then mix. Okay, so now I'm just going to cream my flour and butter mixture. It is all mixed together. I'm going to add it onto my parchment paper and then add it into the fridge to chill. Now that it is out of the fridge, I'm going to roll it to 1/4 inch thick. Alrighty, so now that it is all rolled out to 1/4 inch thick, I'm going to cut my shapes. And then put them onto a mat. So now that these are cut, I'm going to put them in some sugar, and once I'm finished those, then I'm going to head them into the oven. Alrighty, so now we're going to be moving on to our braided loaf. So I already have my water at 95 degrees, and so I'm going to be adding my yeast to it so it can bloom. And in addition with the yeast, I'm going to add the sugar. And then now give that a nice stir. Alrighty, so now that my yeast has poofed, I'm going to pour it into my bowl. And then mix it with my milk powder. And then also add my flour. So I added part of my flour just to get it all going, and then I'm also gonna add the salt to go with it, and I'll continue adding the flour once it mixes. Alright, so now I've transferred into a larger mixer. We're going to mix. So now that the dough is done, I'm going to put it into this bowl. Alrighty, so now the bread has rose, and we're going to split them and to make our braided bread.
Sounds great.
Okay, so right now we're just trying to measure it to make sure that it is the perfect amount. Alrighty, so I measured them all out. They are now all 6 ounces, and so now I'm going to take them and roll them into the long. Alrighty, so I'm gonna pinch the ends and then start braiding my bread. So here's the second loaf. Alright, so here's the finished loaf. We're going to transfer it onto here. And here are my finished loaves once they are out of the oven.